Like to start out with Psalm 77. This is written by King David. And the mighty King David, we hold him up as a hero of faith. We know that God accomplished amazing things through him. And yet he was a person just like you and me. He had his struggles, he has difficulties, and day after day he wrestled with things of faith. He wrestled with God, shall we say. He had his up days and his down days, and every day, like you and I, we wake up, he woke up, putting his faith in the Lord God. These are some verses that maybe you can relate to. I certainly can. So let's read this out loud together. Ready? I cry out to God. Yes, I shout. Oh, that God would listen to me. When I was in trouble, I searched for the Lord. All night long I prayed with hands lifted toward heaven, but my soul was not comforted. I think of God and I moan, overwhelmed with longing for his help. But then I recall all you have done, O Lord. I remember your wonderful deeds of long ago. They are constantly in my thoughts. I cannot stop thinking about your mighty works. O God, your ways are holy. Is there any God as mighty as you? You are the God of great wonders. You demonstrate your awesome power among the nations. By your strong arm, you redeem your people, the descendants of Jacob and Joseph. When we pray in the name of Jesus to the Father, there are things that happen. Jesus says, ask and it will be given you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks, receive. Everyone who seeks, finds. If anyone knocks on the door, it will be opened for him. And so I encourage you to share the things that God has done in your life to others. Not boasting that, boy, I'm such a great believer. The glory goes all to God. But we, you and I, have an opportunity to step in and give testimony. It says, by their testimony and by the blood of the Lamb, they overcame the evil one. That's you and me. Hallelujah. This last section from Psalm 77. We're going to read it between Di and I back and forth. If you have somebody in the room with you that you'd like to do that with, you're welcome to. We've got an A section and a B section. So, pick whatever side you want to. We're just going to do a little back and forth. This is kind of just to give a little illustration of how there is such a give and take in the body of Christ. And sometimes we're giving, sometimes we're receiving, but we need to hear when you speak out loud the things of God. Here we go. When the Red Sea saw you, O God, its waters looked and trembled.
The sea quaked to its very depths.
The clouds poured down rain. The thunder rumbled in the sky.
Your arrows of lightning flashed.
Your thunder roared from the whirlwind. The lightning lit up the world.
The earth trembled and shook.
Your road led through the sea, your pathway through the mighty waters, a pathway no one knew was there. You led your people along that road like a flock of sheep, with Moses and Aaron as their shepherds. Hallelujah. It's important to receive this story of how the Lord led the people of Israel, that is our people, your people. They are our ancestors. We are the descendants of this nation. As if you're a Messianic Jew, these are your people. If you're a Gentile like me, these are your people. Gentiles have been grafted in. And so this is our story as well. So I'd like to close with a blessing. This is right out of the middle of Psalm 77. May you recall what God has done. May you remember the wonderful deeds he's done long ago in your life. May he be constantly on your thoughts. May you not be able to stop thinking about his mighty works, because God is holy and he is yours and we are his.